This is Richie Dotson of AcousticBox.com. I'm here to show you how to remove a non-geared or friction fifth string peg on a banjo and replace it with one that is geared. All right, here's the friction peg that we're going to replace, and here's the geared fifth string peg. It's not just a simple matter of removing this one and installing that one. And to complicate things a little bit more, this is a Grover fifth string peg, the friction one is. And it's actually held together on the side with a little screw. And if you didn't know that, it's pretty easy to get frustrated when making an attempt to remove these. Here's a close-up of that Grover friction peg. And there's that little screw right there. And this is a pretty common problem that you see with these. Here's the screw, but that's only one side of the groove. The other side, the side away from the peg, is actually popped and is missing. Real common on these old tuners. Now here's a good close-up of this. I've got the smallest little screwdriver I have here. Well, that has actually survived anyway. And if you look on the side here, you can see it's actually threaded. This is a Grover, and I got pretty lucky on that one. I consider that very lucky. And there it is. Wow. And there's the head. You can tell a little more about it now that it's out. And you can see the break. Alright, that leaves the hole there. But see what happened? It went in the wood, and then there is a concave area right here on the side of this. And now this can just be turned out. I can do it with my fingers. And there. And there you can see the side of the tuner where the set screw went. I want to show you a few tuners. This is a modern Chinese made friction peg. Comes on the cheapest of the cheap banjos. These aren't designed to last. This is Chinese, possibly Korean. It's among junk, it is king. This is an old one from the 70s, maybe early 80s. Its chrome-plated plastic knob is wonderful. This is an older one. You're getting into much better ones here. Here's the Grover we just removed. Here's a variation on the Grover. It screws in, does not have a set screw. It's not a Grover. Another Grover, and an older Grover. Because the tuner we removed is not the same shaft size as the one we intend to replace it with, there's quite a bit of difference here. We're going to need, and notice also the taper on this, you're going to need a tapered reamer. You can purchase these from Stuart McDonald or First Quality, and probably Janet Davis. All great companies. And I don't remember when the last time I saw one of these, but this is one I've had for 20 years. I bought the thing. They used to sell these at the hardware store, and the tip actually extended out to about here, and it tapered down to a fine point. And I had it in the shop, and I actually ground this tip off till it got down to about where I need it. And the one on the left is the one available from the hardware store, or used to be. The one on the right is Stuart McDonald, and they're pretty close to identical. I think one's slightly larger than the other, which is to my advantage here in the shop. So. Always check the new one before you attempt to ream. You might get semi-lucky, probably not, but also something else you want to do is make sure this isn't leaning forward or toward the head, and actually straight up and down is not a real good idea. Depends on this. This is the nut. Actually, this one's a little screw off which the string will ride. You want it to go down this way. So you just have to pay attention to your angles. I can't tell you exactly how to do this, but right about here is where I intend to place this one for a good angle. With the reamer, a couple times gently. Test fit. Ran into something that's not too uncommon, is the hole isn't deep enough to receive this. I'm going to have to deepen it. Alright, these come in slightly different sizes depending on the manufacturer. This one's from Stuart McDonald, and Godot probably made it for him. It's a 5-star. And this 3/8 seemed to match up. This 3/8 seemed to match up pretty well with the end here. This is the side, not this side back here, but this side's what you want to match this with. Got my handheld drill. Drill press is probably the best bet for this. And that's it. That's all you can do. I'm up against the truss rod in there, so I'm done. All right. Yeah, I got a little more depth on that. That's pretty good. That's as far as it's going to go. Can't force it. Don't want to take any off the end. I'm going to call that fitted. Now, the fit on this, it's actually pretty good. It's nice and snug. One thing you don't want to do, I've made this mistake, if you try to hammer this in even gently, this fret, in this case the 4th fret, most banjos it'll be between the 4th and the 5th, but the 4th is usually the one most affected. This fret and the fingerboard and everything will heave up even slightly, and you'll get this mystery buzz on the 3rd fret, or sometimes even back as far as the 2nd fret. And if that happens and you've done this, you'll know what to look for. Otherwise, sort of push it in finger tight. But because this is only a tapered fit, and I don't want to go so far as to use cyanoacrylate, I'm just going to use a little bit of tight bond. And there you have it. She's all done. Thank you for spending this time with me, Richie Dotson of AcousticBox.com, replacing the friction peg with a geared one. Remember, not all friction or even geared pegs are made the same. And if you're unsure about your project for any reason, call or email if you like. I will see if I can help. Otherwise, have someone do it who's very comfortable with doing things like this. There are many variables, and it's not knowing what to do. It's knowing what to do and what you're doing doesn't go the way you planned. So, from AcousticBox.com, have a great day.